Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video we are going to discuss about bridge rectifier. So first we will see what is mean by bridge rectifier, then the circuit diagram, then output waveform for the same, and some of the advantages and disadvantages of the bridge rectifier. So as you know, rectifier is something which converts AC voltage into the DC voltage. So there is no negative voltage in the DC. So it can be done with the help of full wave rectifier, but the same purpose is fulfilled with the help of bridge rectifier also. So the bridge rectifier circuit is essentially a full wave rectifier circuit using four diodes forming the four arms of a electrical bridge. So here the four diodes are used forming the four diodes, four arms of the bridge. To one diagonal of the bridge, the AC voltage is applied through a transformer if necessary, and the rectified DC voltage is taken from the other diagonal of the bridge. So for one diagonal, that is for this, the AC voltage is applied here, and from other diagonal the AC DC voltage is taken. So the main advantage of this circuit is that if it does not require a center tap on the secondary winding of the transformer. So in full wave rectifier we have seen that we need a center tap on the secondary of a transformer. So because we are using two diodes there, so there we should have a center tap so that the voltage can be divided on the right hand side of the transformer. But here, as we are using a bridge here, we don't want any center tap on the transformer. So it can be treated as an advantage over the full wave rectifier with the two diodes in it. So this is the circuit diagram for that one, for which AC supply is given here. Then a step up transformer is used. So ES equal to EM sin omega t is the voltage at the output of the secondary of a transformer. Then there are four diodes used, D1, D2, D3 and D4, forming the four arms of a bridge. So our input is given at these two opposite arms and output is taken from these arms. So this is the load connected here and this is the ground connection for the circuit. Now coming to the output waveforms, how it looks like. So as we can see here, this is the input cycle which is AC here. Now for during the positive half cycle, D1 and D2 are on. So for positive, D1 and D2 is on, and D3 and D4 are off. So this is not present, and D1 and D2 is off for again positive half cycle, and D3 and D4 on are for negative half cycle. So as you can see, D1 and D2. So these two diodes are on for positive half cycle, means for they will be forward biased during the positive half cycle, and D3 and D4 are on for a negative half cycle, means they are opposite to, so D1 and D4 are opposite. For positive half cycle this is forward biased, and for negative half cycle this is forward biased, so that they can operate in opposite conditions and give the output for whole complete cycle. So if I draw it again, for this one D1 and D2 are on, and for this one D2 and D3. So this output is by D1 and D2, and this is the output due to D3 and D4. So D1 D2 conducts for positive half cycle, so therefore output will be having here. For negative half cycle, D3 and D4 will conduct and we will be having output. So at the output we will be getting the DC pulse for both the cycles by combining these two, because they are combined here. So this is how a bridge rectifier works for giving the complete half cycle. So when we combine these two, we will be getting a DC, a pulsated DC for complete AC. So this AC is shifted to the upper side and we are getting the waveform here. So this is how the output waveforms of a bridge rectifier looks like. And now coming to advantages of a bridge rectifier. The current in both the primary and secondary of the power transformer flows for the entire cycle, and hence for a given power output, power transformer of a small size and less cost may be used. So for the bridge rectifier, current flows for both the primary as well as secondary for both positive and negative half cycles. So a transformer of low cost can be used here, and size also required will be less, and no center tap is required in the transformer secondary. So as I have discussed earlier, no center tap is required in the secondary of a transformer. The currents in the secondary of a transformer are in opposite directions in two half cycles, hence net DC component flowing through the current is so flowing is zero, which reduces the losses and danger of saturation. Then again, as two diodes conduct in series in each half cycle, inverse voltage appearing across diodes gets shared. Hence, the current can be used for high voltage applications and the transformer gets utilized effectively. So, these are the some of advantages of a bridge rectifier over the diode.